Have you ever wondered why steel possesses different mechanical properties that make it applicable in different industries? This variation is primarily due to differences in its chemical composition, especially its carbon content and other alloying elements, as well as the differences in its microstructure. So what is the microstructure of steel? The microstructure refers to how the molecules in steel are bonded together, along with the forces acting between them. Although the microstructure cannot be seen with the naked eye, it can be studied under a microscope. Steel can exhibit a variety of microstructures, including ferrite, perlite, martensite, cementite, and austenite. The heat treatment process alters the microstructure from one form to another, affecting the material's characteristics such as hardness, strength, ductility, and overall mechanical performance. Various methods of steel heat treatment include annealing, normalizing, hardening, and tempering. In this video, we will discuss the tempering process in detail. Welcome to the channel. What is tempering? Tempering, also known as drawing, is a heat treatment process in which steel or a metal is heated to and held at a specific temperature below its critical point for a certain duration. The steel is then cooled to room temperature in still air. Like other heat treatment processes such as annealing and normalizing, tempering modifies the material's undesirable mechanical properties to align them more closely with the intended application. Tempering is usually performed after the hardening process. In the hardening process, the material is heated above its upper critical temperature and then rapidly cooled in water or oil, which is also known as quenching. During quenching, the austenite crystal structure transforms into a martensite crystal structure. Austenite is a face-centered cubic structure that is stable at high temperatures in ferritic steels. The rapid cooling during quenching prevents austenite from transforming into a more stable, low-temperature crystal structure, like ferrite, a body-centered cubic, or perlite. Instead, it becomes martensite, which has a body-centered tetragonal structure. This transformation results in a hard and brittle microstructure with a high density of defects, such as dislocations, which increase the material's hardness and strength. This process can sometimes make the material as brittle as glass. While high hardness is essential for many applications, the accompanying increase in brittleness is often undesirable. To reduce this brittleness and restore ductility, the material is reheated to lower temperatures during the tempering process. The tempering process consists of three stages. They are heating, holding or soaking, and cooling. Heating stage. The first stage involves heating the metal to a lower temperature than that of hardening, typically between room temperature and the lower critical temperature. During this stage, the martensite crystal in steel undergoes recrystallization, reforming into smaller and more stable grains. This process reduces internal stresses within the material. The heating must occur at a controlled rate. If heated too quickly, the metal risks damage due to cracking. The specific temperature and heating rate depend significantly on the type of steel and the desired properties. Holding or soaking stage. The next stage is known as holding or soaking, also referred to as dwelling. In this stage, the metal is held at the predefined temperature below the critical point for a set duration. Once the metal has reached the desired temperature, this holding period allows carbon atoms trapped within the martensite during quenching to diffuse within the material. This diffusion enables the formation of new, less brittle phases, such as ferrite and cementite. Adequate time must be allowed to maximize this stage, and the duration depends on the specific characteristics sought in the material. Cooling stage. The final stage in the tempering process is the cooling stage. During this phase, the component is cooled, typically in air, under carefully controlled conditions. The rate of cooling is crucial and is predetermined based on various factors. The final microstructure consists of a mixture of martensite, ferrite, cementite, and other phases. The arrangement and distribution of these phases significantly influence the material's hardness, toughness, and strength. Types of tempering. Tempering procedures can be classified into three categories based on the heating conditions. They are 1. Low temperature tempering, 2. Medium temperature tempering, 3. High temperature tempering. Low temperature tempering. Low temperature tempering is used to reduce brittleness while maintaining toughness. The tempering temperature for this method falls between 160 degrees Celsius and 300 degrees Celsius. The hardness requirement for low temperature tempering is around 60 on the Rockwell hardness scale. Tools made of plain carbon and low alloy steels typically undergo this treatment. The duration for low temperature tempering is longer than that for high temperature tempering, aiming to achieve a uniform temperature throughout the part. Components subjected to surface hardening and case hardening processes, such as carburizing, cyaniding, or carbonate riding, are also treated with low temperature tempering. Medium temperature tempering. Medium temperature tempering occurs within a temperature range of 300 degrees Celsius to 500 degrees Celsius, resulting in a hardness of approximately 45 on the Rockwell hardness scale. This method is commonly used for spring steel or similar applications where high yield strength and durability are required to withstand torsional stresses and significant bending. Precautions must be taken to prevent embrittlement at a temperature of around 350 degrees Celsius. High temperature tempering. High temperature tempering involves tempering at a temperature exceeding 500 degrees Celsius. The hardness requirement can range from 32 to 65 on the Rockwell hardness scale, depending on the material used. This type of tempering is applied to enhance the toughness of the metal and is primarily utilized for carbon construction steel, high-speed steels, and hot work tool steels. Applications of tempering. Tempering is used across various types of steel to balance hardness and toughness, making the steel less brittle after quenching. It can also be carried out when the material is hardened through other processes such as welding. The high localized temperatures from welding can lead to increased hardness in the heat-affected zones, and tempering can help alleviate these high hardness sections. Additionally, tempering is effective for work-hardened materials, which become hardened through processes like bending, drilling, forming, punching, and rolling. In conclusion, tempering offers crucial benefits that enhance the performance of various products, making them more effective. While tempering provides numerous benefits, it does have potential disadvantages and limitations, such as reduction in hardness, possible surface discoloration or scaling due to the heating process, necessitating additional finishing steps, not being suitable for all materials or applications. If you find this video helpful, please like, share, comment, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell for more content. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Goodbye.